Hey guys, welcome back. This is The Beauty of Me, and I'm back with another video. This one's going to be really different because this is going to be a Scorpio look. And if you want to know how I straighten my hair, I got a video up on my look past that, you know, search it. It's in there somewhere. But yes, my hair has grown a lot since September. It's down here now. I got it cut last year right here, and now it's just down here. But anyway, we're going to get into the video, and I hope you enjoy. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you. Y'all enjoy.
I'm starting off with Maybelline in shade 25, and I'm going to prime my eyes first to be ready for the eyeshadows. I'm blending it out with my fingers, and then after that, I will set it with the NYC loose powder. And then after I set it, I will go ahead and start off with my eyebrows. I'm using the NYX Tammy Frame. And I'm going to do one eyebrow on camera and the other one off camera. And then after I finish blending that out, I'm going to go in with an eyebrow powder. Eyebrow powder. It's a brown powder. You can use any powder you have and just fill in the little gaps that you have. And then after I'm done, I'm going to conceal with this sand sable by NYX. It's the total full coverage. I like it, but I don't like it at the same time because it, like, the texture is really thick and creamy. So I wouldn't recommend using it under your eyebrows, maybe under your eyes for your highlight. So yeah, if you want to use the total coverage by NYX, just use it under your eyes to highlight. Don't use it for your eyebrows because it's really thick. Came back my eyebrows done, everything. The eyes are primed, my face is moisturized. So now I'm gonna go in with the BH Cosmetic Blush in Neutral Palette. I'm gonna go in with a light brown color and start off small and just build up on the brown first and then go in with a darker shade. Just so everything can blend out perfectly. And see, I'm just putting in the light brown in my crease area and towards the end, not all over my lid, just towards the end and the crease area. I'm not focusing too much inside the lid. Now I'm going to Morphe 35W, and I'm going in with a darker shade brown and just going on top with the light brown. Make it just a little bit darker. And the brush, I'm going to use the e.l.f. brush. It's the eyeshadow blending, crease brush. Now I'm going in with the Morphe 35S. It's a colorful palette, and I'm going in with the black And I'm starting off small first because you don't want to start off too heavy and then it's going to be really hard to build up. So you see how I'm just building up on it? And then after I just, you know, place where I want it, I will go in with a fluffier brush and just blend that out. Make sure you will blend it. And see, I'm focusing on the same spot that I put the brown on. And what helps me, I lift my eyebrows so I can be able to get inside my eyes and make sure it's well blended and not don't have any patches. I'm going back in with that same black and building up on it. That brush really didn't work for me, so I used a fluffier brush to try to blend it out some more. This is a different brush. You see, I use a lot of different brushes because I really want that black to be blended out. So I use a lot of small fluffy brushes to just make sure the color is well blended. Now I'm going back with the same concealer, the Maybelline concealer, and I'm going to use a little bit and just tap it on my inner lid. And then after I put it on my inner lid, I'm going to tap it with my pinky or finger and just tap it in and blend it in. And only a little bit because you don't want to have too much concealer to start off with. Then it's going to be really hard to, it's going to start touching your back lid when you lift your eyes up. Then I'm going to go back in and study with the NYC powder. And then I'm going to blend that in with the brown color. Going back in with the brown palette, the first brown I used. And just blend it in. Instead of going with the black, I'm going to use the brown to blend it in. Save me some time. I would say blend it out with a brush first and then coverage, 2 pumped in. Light coverage, 3 pumped in. The 4 pumped in plus is the full coverage. I really like the primer. I mean, it's the foundation because it works really good. And it covers everything. I think the foundation see my matte. I'm just going in with a darker foundation to cover my dark spot. Now I'm going to go in the Anastasia Thick and Shade Golden to highlight under my eyes. It may look a little bright, but I really like it because it's really thick and it full coverage too. So, yeah. I'm going in with a TheBeautyofNe and I just spray my face with the Mario spray. Sasha Buttercup powder, and I really like this powder because it has a golden undertone in it, and it don't give you flashback. That's the key. I love it. And I ordered it from Amazon. Now I'm going to go in the BS Cosmetic powder palette, and I'm going to use the 2 darkest shade on the end just to mix it in to contour my face. Lips. first. It's just a regular brown piece I got from the hair store. No, it's not my lip first before I put the ruby blue lipstick on. To clean up my, you know, outside of my lip that I messed up on, just clean it up. And all of them, just fixing up my hair, spraying my face and everything. And after I spread it, the key to not having like a powdery look is going back in with that beauty blender and just tapping everything in, getting away, getting the excess product off. And that's the finished product of this look. I hope you really enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye.